Hey guys, I wanted to show you how to fillet a sunfish. Basically, what you're trying to do is remove the head, the skin, and the bones. That's the bone structure. You've got this spine area, that's all bones. You've got a rib cage, and then it's kind of a flat spine out to the tail. So the way I access a sunfish, first thing I do is take the head off. If you take an angle, you want as much meat as you possibly can. So take an angle above the gill. I use a serrated blade to take the head off, and then I use a nice flexible sharp fillet knife to do the rest of the filleting. That makes your blade last a lot longer because you've cut through the bones and the scales with the fillet knife that way, or with the serrated knife that way. These are about $16. That's a Rapala 4-inch fillet knife, by far the nicest knife for the price. Okay, so you've cut the head off. Now you have a visual access of where that rib cage is and where the spine line is. So by cutting the head off, I can see that spine line, and I want to put the knife as close to that as possible. I slide it in, and I'm actually pushing down and pushing down against that with my index finger against that spine, and then I just slide out. This is where you tend to lose the most meat. If you come in another way and you're a little bit of ways away from that, you end up leaving a bunch of meat behind. Once I've gone out to the end of the rib cage, I pop through and I go out to the tail. Then I put a little pressure on and I start to turn the fillet over top of that rib cage. Once I've gone, barely a quarter of an inch, I just tear the rest of it off. Now I've got it flipped open. The beauty of these knives, they're flexible. They lay flat on the table if you push them down. So I push down, slide out to the end, and that's your fillet. There's usually a little weird piece of fatty meat right on the top of that fillet. Crappy have this too. You definitely want to take that off or make sure that's left behind. Some of that was left behind right here on the skin. Now on the other side, it's even easier because I can watch my blade on the back side. So I'm going to slide that in, and then I flip the fish over so I can press down again on that spine. Come out to the end. I popped through on that back fin, out to the tail. Start again here, just get it started. Maybe a half inch over top of the rib cage. Lay it down flat on the flat table and push my blade flat when I'm cutting the skin off. I take that nice and flat off. Check and make sure I didn't leave that fatty strip. That fatty strip is actually on here. There's a little piece of it right there. You want to make sure that's off the fillet. There's your fillet. And there's the carcass. You can see right through that. There's really not much meat left behind at all. There's nothing on this. And that's a cleaned up fillet. Once you get quick with it, you can cut those things in about 50 seconds a piece. And we have some to do here today. If you'd like to see more videos, Rogers Rigs, please subscribe. Check out my website. I have some lures, what we catch these fish on. That is a great place to go. Rogers Rigs will show you the techniques and tricks we use to catch buckets of fish. And that's Hannah's first big lake trout.
I named it after me. It's Hannah, like me.
Yep, and she wants to put the head up on the wall. Thanks for watching.